night. It's June 4th. Me and G-Unit here, down here at the Tulpehockin Creek. Got quite a few fish rising up here, seems like right now, so hopefully we have a good evening of fishing. Want to give a shout out to TCO Fly Shop. They gave us some good recommendations of what to use down here, so we're going to go see if we can reel some trout in for you guys. Stay tuned.
Tyler's got one hooked.
Got a nice trout here.
Nice brown trout. What'd you get him on?
Sulfur. Oh.
And there he goes.
So here we are. Here we are at State College today. State College is kind of a fly fishing mecca in Pennsylvania. Many excellent trout fishing streams in the State College area, and we're fortunate enough to have with us a renowned guide in the area, J. Andrew Greiner, also known as Jimmy. And Jimmy's joined us for the day to guide us here today. We'd like you to take notice of some of the fly fishing equipment and accessories that Andy is equipped with. First of all, you'll see his fly fishing tray. It flips open like this. It's like a desktop right in front of him. So he's actually working today. This is a desktop.
This is his desktop.
Yeah. Flips open like this. All fine selection of flies. Quite a variety.
Table for my texting.
He can put his cell phone there as long as he doesn't tilt it and it falls in the water. Then he has a problem. But as you can see, an excellent selection of flies. Now he has his tippet ring here. Various types of tippet. How many are on there? 1, 2, 3, 4.
I think size.
He has six spools of tippet. Probably one would be enough, but we have six today. And this tool here, Andy, tell us exactly what this tool is for.
That helps me tie some knots that's the nail knot tool.
That's his nail knot tool, and of course he's got his little
toothache.
Tweezers there. If you have to pull his teeth, he's got
trim
his nails. And not only does he fish well, but he's well groomed while he's doing it. Yeah. Now, if you walk around the side here a little bit, Grant, you notice he's got his net and it's secured to his back, long. Now, Andy, doesn't this extend?
It's a magnet.
It's a magnet. Oh. Of course it's magnet. It's magnet loaded. Only the finest in fishing gear for Jimmy. This is what a pro, see that? See what a pro looks like. Now, here you'll notice he has a fold-up wading stick as well, strapped to his belt. I mean, when you have one of them, you're a fly fisherman.
That saves so many flies that they get caught in the tree.
Mm-hmm. He's probably beating back bears with that thing. He's done all kinds of stuff with that. Yeah. He's done all kinds of stuff with that. And then topped off with a fly fishing hat, keeps the sun off of your face, and looks cool, and a set of $300 sunglasses. So when you're equipped like that, you're ready for a day of fly fishing in central Pennsylvania.
The question is, are the fish ready for this?
The fish will not know what hit them today. So
we're here at the Tulpehockin Creek, June, up here at the waterworks, me and Big G. Let's see what we can get.
Definitely a trout, I think. You know, once
you get him in.
Ooh, that's a big boy. Oh. Big brown. Big brown right there.
Let's see. Oh, wow. Wow, that's got some good girth to it.
Got some good girth to it.
First cast on an ant. Hold him up here if you can for a good look.
Not the largest. Oh, there he goes.
All right, Grant just hooked up with one. I think on a pheasant tail, is that correct?
Yep. But you had pheasant tail now.
Same poison for these fish as last night.
think it's a nice rainbow, so.
We were just at Clark Creek last night. We're back at it again tonight on the Tully. So, trying to fish as much as we possibly can here as it's getting late in the season while it's still decent fishing.
Yeah, you start to see that fish. Soon start
pretty
seeing
sure it's a rainbow.
Ooh, yeah, he's flopping around.
So, yep. Coming over.
He's a fighter, that's for sure. Well, that's a big one.
Another fish that's not really very long, but it's got a lot of girth to it. Just like yours.
Got him.
There we go.
That's a nice size fish.
That is a nice size fish.
Alright.
Man, it's a feisty one too. Let's see if I can hold him up here for you to see. Nice size rainbow trout here on the Tully.
There you
go. Not very long, but
definitely got a lot of mass to it.
Yeah.
They're eating good down here.
Yeah, for sure. Alright, we'll let him go here.
Here we are, just about to go fishing. There was a couple doe right down by the creek. Nice rainbow.
Did you see the thing flying
here? Mm-hmm. Took a pretty good jump, didn't it?
Try to hold him up here if you can. Hold it up a little bit. There he is.
Nice job, nice. Cards.
So today is July 4th in 2014, and we're going to go trout fishing at Pine Creek. And some of us have fly rods, and some of us are using spinners.
Alright, just hooked a trout on a light Cahill dry fly. Brown trout.
That's the one that tried to get mine. That's the one I have, I'm pretty sure.
There he is. Nice little brown trout.
Oh, we got a bald eagle right here. Right here in this tree. Oh, there it's... its nest is right here. It's pretty cool. Saw this here yesterday, actually. Saw the bald eagle, but we didn't see the nest. Dad's got one here. I think that's our fifth fish today. We got him on the that blue-winged olive nymph again. It's a nice rainbow.
My dad and my brother have been catching all the fish the last 2 days, and I started to realize that my brother and my dad are catching all the fish on beadhead nymphs, so I thought I'd tie a beadhead on. Third cast, whatever. Got him on.
Decent brown.
Yeah.
There's another fish that swims by that rock or something. I literally just saw that fish move up there.
Yep.
There he is.
This fish has been pretty aggressive in feeding. We've seen it rise several times. And I was using nymphs earlier, but after seeing it constantly rise and been pretty consistent, I put the dry fly on.
That's a nice brown.
That's nice, yes. That's a pretty big one.
Yeah.